찬스.
그래. 아, 나또 안나려. 나도 찬스.
1994 was the first time I came over. 97 I came and I was here for about 3 years, and then I went to the States. And I think a marriage is directly tied to having that basis of love and mutual respect is really important, but you also have to kind of fulfill both your own desires, I guess, or your goals in life, and you have to meet the goals in life of your spouse. I went back to the States to get an MBA, and I tell people I went home to get an MBA, and instead I got a divorce and then drunk for 3 years, and then I got an MBA. So I moved back to China and started out working as an English teacher in 2012 and got a job at a German consulting company and then opened this place. Getting more and more locals that come in and just want to drink really good beer. It's easy to make beer, it's difficult to make good beer, and it's nearly impossible to make really good beer that tastes the same every time. But it's basically barley, water, hops, and yeast, and you grind it up and soak it in hot water, basically like making tea, and then you boil that liquid and you store it and wait till it's done fermenting.
This is a fermenter.
One of the things that people don't understand about making beer is that the mineral content of the water is extremely important. The craft beer market is growing slower than we thought it would in Chongqing. But it's still growing. If our business ends up failing and we have to go back to the corporate world, I can go find work and make enough money to be comfortable. I think I kind of knew deep down inside the first time I was married that this wasn't somebody I could raise kids with. And so it was not gonna last. And my current wife, I knew we could raise a family together, so.
我第一次看到他的时候，我觉得他很可爱，因为他很胖嘛，我从来都没有见过这么胖的一个人，就在我的生活当中。 以后呢，李灿呢就跟我说，他说：“妈妈，我交往了一个外国人。”我说：“外国人是哪个国家呢？”他美国的。看着豆子，想到第二个宝宝，我觉得如果是个女儿是更好，是个儿子也可以。
for this.
Hey Joseph, do you want some? Do you want some? Do you want some chocolate?
Yeah.
1 mm dough. Okay. But you have to come over and sit on my lap and answer my questions. Oh, there we go. What's this?
Brother and sister.
Brother and sister? What do you want? Do you want a brother or a sister?
Brother.
Why?
Because
that's
a little bit of fun.
Because what?
That's my
friend. It's your friend? What's a friend? Hey, be careful.
笨就问我，他说你有没有一个男朋友呀？我说没有。
And then I said, "Do you want a boyfriend?" And she said,
我说看缘分吧。
She got out of the cab, and then I asked the cab driver, like, "What does that mean?" Because I didn't know what "缘分" meant. And he didn't really say anything. And I said, "Does that basically mean I'm screwed?" And he's like, "Yeah, pretty much." I kept calling her, and she kept saying that she would go out on a date.
我估计从那个时候开始，就是正式跟他一起算朋友吧。
Very cool, man. Oh shit! Let's go to a different bar, man. This place is great.
One of the things we could be doing better here is having different events every night that we can advertise.
Tonight we've got Catherine who's doing some stand-up for us. Okay, I think that's better. Is that better?
Yeah.
All right. Good evening. My name is Ben. That means stupid in Chinese. I'm not the comedian, so don't laugh at anything I say. Pretty funny than I am, so welcome, Catherine.
Yeah!
She's from Quebec.
When you're a girl, it's really easy to get messages, but quantity is not quality. Just finish words. We have sex, can we? I never met you. I love you. I love you. You never met me. This one actually happens a lot. So thank you, all these guys, for some material here. Thank you so much.
We made it.
My Chinese friends suggested that I open a bar. And that's a big part of Chinese culture is having what they call guanxi, that in China that's what's important. And one of my oldest friend in China, a guy named Yao Wei, if I hadn't met him and some of his friends back in 1994, and we hadn't connected the way we did, it's possible that my China experience would have ended in 1994 like everybody else's did. So if there's one group of people that I could thank for the situation I'm in now, it's them.